Welcome back to Real on Real Issues, the show that examines a modern issue through the lens of an old movie. This week, we're taking a break from America's fraught political climate to examine a lighter issue, like the impending destruction of our planet due to harmful energy practices. I know what you're thinking. That's even heavier. But don't you worry. We'll do it through the lens of a beloved early 2000s Disney movie. So let's watch a trailer.
The creators of Toy Story.
Good morning, fellas.
Hey, what's shaking, bacon?
Did you lose weight or a limb?
Take you into the world behind your closet door.
Roz, you're looking fabulous today. Is that a new haircut? New makeup. You've had a lift. You've had a tuck. You've had something.
We can neither confirm nor deny the presence of a human child.
Let's keep it. I always wanted a pet that could kill me. What are you doing?
Monsters Incorporated.
It's a musical.
Monsters, Inc. is the story of an energy mining plant at the center of Monstropolis. The factory is huge, with countless billowing smokestacks. On top of that, the door vault in which the company stores the portals used to mine energy from children's screams is seemingly endless. Monsters, Inc., the company, not the film, has been allowed to grow so large because of the Monster World's reliance on it.
The future is bright at Monsters Incorporated.
I'm in this
We're
one.
Part
I'm
of
in
your
this one.
Life. We power your car. We warm your home. We light your city.
I'm Monsters Incorporated.
Hey, look, Benny!
Carefully matching every child to their ideal monster to produce superior scream, refined into clean, dependable energy. Every time you turn something on, Monsters Incorporated is there.
I'm Monsters Incorporated.
Of course, MI is prepared for the future with the top scarers, the best refineries, and research into new energy techniques.
We're MI, Monsters Incorporated. We scare because we care.
But there's a problem. Children in the human world are becoming harder to scare and are screaming less and less. An energy shortage seems imminent for the Monster World. And for the audiences watching Monsters, Inc. in the 21st century, an impending energy shortage, unfortunately, should seem imminent to them as well. There are striking similarities between Monsters Incorporated and fossil fuel industries. The Monsters Incorporated commercial from the 2001 movie is eerily reminiscent of commercials from current gas and energy manufacturers. Observe.
When we made our commitment to the Gulf, BP had two big goals. Help the Gulf recover and learn from what happened so we could be a better, safer energy company. We've added cutting-edge safety equipment and technology, like a new deep water well cap and a state-of-the-art monitoring center where experts watch over all our drilling activity 24/7. Our commitment has never been stronger.
Despite efforts to convince the public otherwise, all uses of non-renewable energy are harming our planet's future. Extracting, transporting, and burning fossil fuels is extremely damaging to ecosystems and the planet in its entirety. According to the U.S. Energy Information Administration, at the current rate of extraction, oil reserves will last humans less than 60 years. Fossil fuels just aren't sustainable. It seems darkly appropriate that in Pixar's allegory for the fossil fuel industry, the unsustainable source of energy is children's screams. Because they're who we need to be thinking about. In the movie, Boo is a child from the human world who finds herself in the monster world. Our monster protagonists discover that Boo's laughter has a powerful effect on the monster world's electricity. In fact, a child's laughter is 10 times stronger than their screams. This new piece of information in the monster world fits easily into the energy industry analogy. Boo's laughter is the monster world's solar power. Though this discovery holds the potential for new, sustainable energy, the profit-minded antagonists are developing the Scream Extractor, a more dangerous and damaging method used to extract the same diminishing resource. Now, this rhetoric should sound familiar. It's the same tactic companies like Shell and BP are taking with oil through new processes like fracking. For those of you who don't know, the process of injecting liquid into the earth to force open existing fissures and extract oil or gas, that's fracking. Of course, the morals of the real world aren't as black and white as that of a Disney cartoon, but one would hope that the morals of the real world would exist. Now we go to the Real on Real Issues panel. This week, we're joined by the complete Real on Real team. My producers, Melissa Marin and James Fitzpatrick, are here. So together, we'll discuss the issue and film of the week further. So we're covering a pretty heavy topic this week, and I'd like to hold talking about it off a moment longer. So I'm going to start off with the question, what did you guys think of Monsters, Inc.?
I don't know. Monsters, Inc. was never my favorite as a kid. I think there are other ones that always stuck with me more, but I never hated it.
I'm at the other side of it from you. I love this movie. This was the first movie I ever saw in theaters. I was one at the time, but I don't remember watching it, but my mom says I enjoyed it. What did you think about the movie, Melissa?
Honestly, I loved Monsters, Inc. But I'm also like, I usually get very emotionally attached to movies. So it's just one of those things where as long as there's a moment where or an opportunity to cry, I'm usually in love with it.
Every time Boo cries, I cry. Okay, so this is a movie all about scaring, and personally, I'm scared of the future of the planet, so I think we can transition into our story of the week, and I want to know if either of you have any thoughts on the climate crisis and the energy crisis.
Well, considering the fact I'm in California, it affects me almost every day, especially because we literally, instead of considering it like hurricane season or like winter and how we deal with snow in New York, I'm like dealing with the fact that we have fire season and that it's not always just the heat or the dryness, but actually the wind. And it could literally be someone smoking and then the cigarette ends up in a brush and then it creates a brush fire that then creates a huge fire and then the entire state is clouded in just smoke.
Just from a New Yorker standpoint, it's not something you can wrap your head around, the fact that there's a fire that's lasting as long as it does, to the point that you have to get used to the fact that your state is on fire and that the sky looks the way it looks.
Even like going on hikes and seeing the, you know, acres and acres of land that were on fire, it still takes 2 to 3 years to have any type of growth.
Yeah, so just to hear that is happening in our country is just crazy.
It's beyond heartbreaking, but the thing that really boggles my mind is that how is this a political issue? There is legitimate environmental proof that the current way we harvest our resources in the name of energy is having disastrous effects on our planet.
Like, all you have to do is go outside to see the effects of it. It's like, if you think about when it starts getting cold in New York versus 5 years ago when it started getting cold in New York, it is not the same. It's the weather is messed up here. Like,
I think there's actually been times where my friends from New York are like, it's hotter here than it is in California. And it's the weirdest thing to ever hear.
So, I mean, I bring this up in our opening for this episode, but how are we in a place where neither of the presidential candidates were able to disavow fracking?
It's kind of the same mentality as they had in Monsters, Inc. in regards to the fact that they are making more money by doing that and being more profitable, because I don't think we all realize how we utilize oil every day. And like the fact that oil is in your clothing. And to think that we would try and take something away that would help all of these for-profit companies, they're looking at it as a loss of business. And they're only thinking about the now versus the future.
It's a financial issue. I mean, you have Water Noose, the villain of Monsters, Inc. I'll kidnap 1,000 children before I let this company die. Water Noose was this CEO, and we just, our country was just controlled by a CEO whose cabinet was filled with other titans of industry.
Well, I also think that ties back into Disney, and like we said before, how Disney is so good at hiding their messages in a kids' movie. And if you look at other examples too, I mean, WALL-E, you have the future of Earth. It's unlivable. And you have a bunch of overweight, obese humans living in space because we can't live on Earth anymore. So
I think bringing up WALL-E is a tremendous point. But, you know, at the current rate we're going, where in 60 years we're going to be out of oil, all of us being fat blobs in a chair on a spaceship seems like an optimistic future.
Yeah, because we're alive.
So that's a lot of scary stuff to consider. But remember, folks, we scare because we care. We started this episode with the intention to address a non-political issue, but it became one nevertheless. Most things are political these days, and while that can be exhausting, they need to be. Regardless of the outcome of the presidential election, it's the responsibility of the next generation to stay informed and call for necessary change. There is more than the quality of the planet at stake, but its very existence. That's on us. I know that's a lot of pressure, so take a deep breath, maybe go watch a movie, but when you're done, let's get to work. So, stay informed, stay vigilant, and stay sane out there. Thanks for tuning in.